Right then, hi guys, let me know you can hear me this week. Ooh, webcam's freezing a bit. Right, just bear with me, let me pause this one down here. I've got myself in repeat loads of times. Welcome to the quiz tonight. It is week, what are we on, 18? 18 in tonight's quiz. Someone ping me a message, let me know you can hear me. I think I've sorted the microphone out. Yeah, unbelievable, week 18. Still going strong. Cat is lying on. I don't know if anyone can see this. I've got a cat down here, lying on the keyboard. Well, let me move the keyboard so his head's not resting on the spacebar. There we go. Right. So, welcome again. How many teams we got on? Let's see where we are. 53 teams joined up so far. Got a good quiz for you tonight. We've gone back to basics. I feel we've gone back to basics. We've had quite a few complicated rounds recently, I've had to explain. Picture rounds, there's one music round tonight, I think, and, you know, a few questions, lots of pictures. It's a good one, I like tonight. It's different. So, for those who are on early, your rounds tonight, food and drink, cocktails, kids' books, fashion. Someone asked for fashion last week, I think it was Sarah Pond asked for fashion, so doing a round on fashion. You've got general knowledge, movies, a round on fruit, a guest round this week. The person who's done this round wants to remain anonymous. They're calling themselves Co. Vincent Van Cough. They have drawn, the round's called Badly Drawn Dinosaurs. It's funny. They've got mass celebs and then calendar to finish off. I feel like we've got two lots of music playing from somewhere and I don't know where from. Why have we got two lots of music? Let's see. Right. We have. There we go. I've changed the music tonight. I've gone with a bit of happy upbeat in the background, but the other whole music suddenly kicked in as well. So let's see who we have got playing. Alright, who's on Facebook? A couple of messages coming through on Facebook. So, Hilary Chorn has just asked to join the group. We have online. First one's on tonight, Metal Rise. I'm guessing that's Tim down on the beach in Charmouth Beach. Smoking the Bandit, the Casties, President Pedro. Still don't know who these Napoleon guys are. Let me know. Nicholas over in Norway. Sure, we've got a few more Norwegians joining tonight. I've got the Brown Eyed Ladies. There's the Murphy Doyles. We've got Luke, it's Malvin. Combining forces tonight. Combining forces. Consistently Poo. Thank you for changing your name so it's child friendly. Yeah, that's Gibbon Keeley. We've got Quizzy Lizzie. Who's that? Rob Bailey. There, the Mount Pleasant Pheasants did really well last week. We've got Scumbag College. Johnny Knowledge, John and Joanne hiding behind me. There they are, John and Joanne on the sofa. Where are they? John and Joanne on the sofa. In Shrewsbury. There's the Dales. Simcox are back. The Tharby's back this week. Route 55 with a new picture, Carol and Jem with the kids. There's the Barwell, Spreading Way Sausages. We've got Stefan. Tone. Oh, sorry, I'm showing them behind. There's Stefan and Tone. Bembo's, Brian and Andy. We've got Mickey, Minnie, and Dumbo. Draft Call Bob. Captain Bill's back. Andy Rara. Andy and Rach. Chilton and the Wheelies. That's Cara Roberts. My name's Ecke, and I'm. Let's see what it says. I've waited for the tooltip come up. I don't think you can see it on the main screen. No tooltip. Let's try again. And I'd rather be playing golf. Cheers. I've got Dwight Schrute. There's the Lindos Lunds. Right. Oh, it's just suddenly jumped all over the place. So Clifford Turner's just joined. Normally do quite well. There's my dad and Pat. Pat and Don. I've got Kate and Simon. Great picture, Kate. The Berry 4 plus 2, they brought on reinforcements this week. Okay, messages coming through on Facebook. Let me know you're playing. So Mal, an advan posted a picture with Scarlet. Scarlet's awake still. Hi Scarlet. Got to see what you're doing. Right, Northern Taffies and Baz and Rach going solo this week after their combined effort last week, says Stephen O'Donovan. Advan says we've combined tonight. It's Luke, it's Team Melvin. Who else have we got on here? There's Runa over in Norway. Hope your mum's feeling better. We've got Tripper Snipper. Wow, that name. Tripper Snipper. The Valiant Ducks have just joined. Can't get your picture up yet. The Moss Rats. Right, so 82 teams so far, 10 minutes to go. You're on tonight, I'll run through again. If you've never taken part before, I'm sure everyone has by now, I recognise most of these names, but if you haven't, this is where you need to go to answer the questions tonight. www.ecke.uk. Big shout out to everyone that plays after. I got told last week we are getting quite a lot of people, we get quite a lot of views. People watching this and the the nights that follow. So hi to everyone that is playing on a Tuesday or a Wednesday. And from next week, because it wouldn't let me do it, I say up too late this week, we're moving over to a new YouTube channel, taking everything off my personal YouTube. We're going to move it across into a proper quiz YouTube channel. So for anyone that does subscribe to the YouTube, please look out next week. I will be posting about it tomorrow. But we are moving over to a new YouTube channel, just so I can keep all the quiz stuff separate from my own personal things. My own personal YouTube account sort of been run over a little bit by the quiz. But anyway, tonight, love tonight's quiz. Quite simple. We have food and drink, cocktails, kids' books, fashion, general knowledge, movies, fruit. Movie round, by the way. We haven't had one like this. This is a picture round. Guess the movie. We've not had one then for a long time. Got a round on fruit, a round from COVID St. Van Koff. He wants to remain anonymous. Badly drawn dinosaurs. He's providing me with some badly drawn dinosaurs. Mass celebs and calendar. Our guest round tonight is by someone who normally comes into the pub, so that narrows it down a little bit. Someone who normally has been taking part in the quiz for years, actually in the pub, but he doesn't want to be named. Right, hi to the Franklins over in Abbey and all the other Abbey guys. Good to have you back. Hope everyone's enjoying their 6 weeks holiday if you're at school, off school. For a lot of people, it makes absolutely no difference whatsoever. Let's see who else is joining them. We've got sugar-free gum. We've got the middle witch. Count Custody. He's done it. Oh, that's my neighbour. With Sergeant Dickie Davies. There you go. From Middlewich Custody Department Police Station. Fanny and Jim are back. I didn't see you last week. Welcome back, Fanny and Jim. We have Piaf Carl. Oh, hiding behind me. Let's move me out of the way so we can see. Piaf Carl, and then we've got the Three Dings. Great Bradley Wiggins. The Rollsies have just joined. There they are, the Rollsies. Just hiding off the bottom. Got him, his, and Doors. Just the two of us. The Rabbits. Mr. and Mrs. C. Dan, Beth, and Big Bad Moody. The Veggie Mighties know they're a team from down south. Abbey United, that's got the... that's Sharon's team tonight. The Lovets are on. So, captained by Jack tonight. Does that mean Jack gets to overrule Georgia on all the questions? I'm sure Georgia gets the final say on it all. Anyway, shout out to Barry, who's decorating up Glasgow Way, up in Scotland. I think Gavin Paul, I did see two tanks, two Brits, no tank tonight, so I'm assuming it's just Gavin Paul playing over in the States. It's amazing we've got people playing in the States, I think Malta. And... yeah, Scotland. Let me know where you are if you're not in Staffordshire, if you're somewhere different. Sorry, my phone's just ringing. Runa saying, thanks for remembering mum's fine back home and ready for the quiz. Even made my dad during this time. So, hi to Runa's mum and dad over in Norway. tried to keep the questions international. The tiny couple of probably British questions, but tried to keep it as international as possible, as we have, do have people playing all over the world. So hopefully you'll do quite well. 120 teams, not sure how many we'll get on tonight. Life's getting very much back to normal, unless you're in Manchester. Miss Annie G's back. And we've got Ian and Rach. So, just, I can see through my camera, Scarlett's waving, so I'll wave back. Hi, Scarlett. Tinky Winky. There's Tim. Tim is Tim who provides our fantastic Tim's Tunes rounds. It was meant to be Tim's Tunes tonight. I've postponed it till next week. Tim's Tunes is back next week. We've got Bessie. There's Kerry. Mo's Magic hiding behind me. I'll get you up in a minute. We've got Carol Baskin. I did it. Sarah and Steve are playing. We've got Robertson. A Smugsy on yet. I'm not seeing Smugsy join yet. Apologies to Smugsy if they are on here. They have now won multiple times, and I always forget that they previously won. They won last week. Apparently, it's their third time. Not sure if they changed names, but they did message me today. I always forget that they've won. So, well done to Smugsy. I think they're our leaders so far. I think they're the only people that have won multiple times so far. We've got the Hills in. They're the Hills. Here we go. There's Mo's Magic. Oh, still hiding behind me. Let's get you up. Just peeking out. We've got Katie Crop joining. We've got 99 problems, but the beach ain't one. Not top five talent tonight, Tom. Interesting to see how everyone does tonight. I like tonight's quiz. It is simple. A few pitch rounds, one music round, nothing too complicated. So only one YouTube round. I'm waiting for the Berries who volunteered to do me another dance round. It didn't come through in time for this week, but I'm holding you to that. here we go. Team name. There's the captain. So what have we got on the YouTube? We have 117 watching on YouTube. Ray Johnson saying fizzrable as muck is checking in. Hi, Roy. Tom Beach logged on. Got Tim Leader down in Charmouth Beach. Think he was the first one on tonight. There's Baz and Rachel. They've split from the parents tonight. They're going alone. There's the Berries. We've got Come On You Saints. The Fletchers are back. Callie and Matt. Callie does our fantastic xylophone round. I hope she's practicing some new songs for us. Cat Biscuits and the little one there on the picture. Got the Squires in Manic Monday. Shout out to the MCs on. Jamie Machin's still playing. Jamie never missed a Monday night. Rarely missed a Monday night anyway. At the pub and all the Chaddocks. Kanye for President. Who was that? We've got Cotton Town. Can't see some of these because my face is in the way. Anyway, we've got a few minutes, so this way you need to go, www.ecke.uk. 50 multiple choice questions. If you've never played before, dead easy. Just click on the correct answer on the app, go to that site, sign in. There's a bug in the system for some reason, you have to sign in twice. I still haven't got to the bottom of it. We'll take a look this week. But yeah, that's it. Rounds of five questions, so there's a bit in for everyone tonight. Right, Sarah and Russ Thomas, the Toms from Ivy Bank, checking in. I know we get quite a few of you Ivy Bank guys in, so hello to all the Ivy Bankers. Almost said that wrong. 171 teams now, come on, let's get up to 200 tonight. I've still got a couple of mates, we normally have an influx at the last few minutes. So, got the Shropshire Stars. I missed them before. There's the Shropshire Stars. Oh, can't get them on. There they are. We've got Heidi High, just the two of us. Tone and V. The Durbrains Trust. Yeah, there's the Middlewich Custody Department again. Him and Hazen Doors got Faulty Towers, Saharan Kayaking Club. Right, more joining in now, half a chance. Don's got Gnomes Down South, captained by Tom tonight. We've got Michael Scott. Leesley's Leeds, JLC, Maiden Darwin, Linda and Alfie. Playing down south. And we've got Allah, we've got Bruce 2020, Stan the Man, Medley Relay Matthews. Okay, so let's give it a few more minutes. Like I say, life is getting back to normal. We dropped a few teams the past few weeks. I suppose it is the holidays. Do want to get the team numbers back up though, so we need to publicise. If anyone can get me on a Congleton group, Congleton group's banners from advertising. Don't know why. Tried on the Congleton chats back group, and they refused to post any adverts for the quiz. Just before we start, Tom Beach saying, has Johnny Burgess had his shout out yet? He's not yet. No shout out for Johnny. As you all know, I think, is his team name Johnny? No. New Camera Hort. There we go. There's Johnny tonight. You need to get a picture of Johnny for the fans. We are the lead fans in the Johnny Burgess fan club on this quiz. Johnny gets a shout out every week. He's starting to get recognised in supermarkets and shout outs in the supermarket, I believe. Hopefully he's recovered from his relegation in his fantasy football league. Right, so it is half past. Let's give it a few more seconds before we start. Shut up, Jazz is on. Sorry, S, the Old Arms. There's Diane. We've got Wilmslow. Won't be a quiz without Wilmslow taking part. Legends of the Towers. Steve-O, just the donkey, just joined in. The McFittens. Right, almost up to 200 teams, so just give it a few more minutes. Your round tonight, those people just joining, just logging on to Facebook, YouTube. Your categories, food and drink, cocktails, kids' books, picture round on fashion, we've got general knowledge, we've got a picture round which is movies, we've got a music round called fruits, we've got badly drawn dinosaurs, we've got masks of lebs, which is a picture round, and calendar. I think it's quite easy quiz tonight, we'll see. I do think it's quite an easy quiz tonight. So I'm expecting some high points, a couple of real toughies in. You know, have to throw the odd one in. But yeah, let's see. Oh, apparently tone is pronounced tune. 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 I've just been told by Nicholas. Did Ruth and John join? Can't see them, I don't know. Ruth and John, are you on? Let's have a look for you. I've been told to look out for you. Oop. Just lost my sight. Hopefully that's not going to mess things. Oh, we hit 200 teams. Brilliant, hit 200. Last ones to join. Got Agatha Quizzity on. Late joiner tonight. Got the buyer next door. Rob and Laura next door. Got Ostipop and Mill, Steve-O. Tater Tots are in. Can't see Smugsy tonight. They changed the name. Dan Bauer saying, will there be controversy this week? Hopefully not. Hopefully not. But you never know. Every week I've checked and checked and checked. And today, before I started work today, I sat and went through a dry run of the quiz. Checked all the questions. You never know though, do you? I don't think so. I think I've got everything right tonight. Convinced I've got everything right. Tim saying, hello Team Macro 4. I know lots of Macro 4 people on tonight. Right, what are we up to? 201 team, shall we make a start? Alright, let's get ready to make a start. I know you all want to get on with this. Right, switch over to this. Oh, that's not the screen you want to see. That's the chat window, bear with me. Here we go. Oh, I've froze now. Let me try and refresh the webcam. There we go. Right. 201 teams taking part tonight. Everyone ready? Here we go. First round is food and drink. Normal general knowledge food and drink questions. Oh, just another couple of teams just joining in the nick of time. Who are they? Nantwich Star and HHH. So, let's go. Here we go. Right, so what colour is Demerara sugar? Is it white, yellow or brown? What colour is Demerara sugar? White, yellow or brown? So I missed that Jamie and Bryony are playing tonight. So I missed that during the rundown of photos. Hi to Jamie and Bryony. What colour is Demerara sugar? George D was quick there. George D and DHD quick. Mount Pleasant Pheasants. Yeah, that's brown, 97%. Good start there, 97% of you getting that right. Demerara sugar is brown. Not that I can spell. Demerara. Right, the fact that that is spelt wrong worries me. That does worry me. Because I thought I'd fix that. This could go horribly wrong tonight now. I thought I'd updated the quiz. We will see. We will see. Oh, God. Oh, God. Right, here we go. Number two. Venison is the name of a meat from which animal? Venison is the name of meat from which animal? Is it goat, deer, cow or sheep? George D, quick there. Maren Park, Clifton is the three dings. Nantwich Star, fit and D and can't be bothered. Fast his finger there. So venison's the meat of a deer. Again, 98%. George D in top place, then Maren Parr. Yeah, spelled venison wrong as well. Not doing well tonight. We're not doing well at all. Thanks for that, Beck. I am worried. I thought I corrected that. There were a few mistakes in the quiz when I did a dry run through this morning. I uploaded a new version. I'm just hoping it's applied. Otherwise, there could be a disaster tonight. So just bear with me because I have no idea why that isn't working. Let me just detach this window. Right, next question. What's the name of the Asian dish of spiced meat and vegetables and pastry triangles? Is it samosa, bhaji, pakora or aloo gobi? DHD quicker, Nantwich Star quick. Sally H quick, that must be Sally Hughes. George D, Maren Parr, Back to the Future, Napoleon, Tater Tots quick there. So that is samosa, 97% again. Everyone getting these right. Lots of 3 out of 3s, I'm sure. So DHD, quickest on time, moving up 2 spots. George D moving down one. Yeah, I am worried about this tonight now. I am worried, I've got to admit. It could go horrendously wrong. But let's see. Number four, what name is given to a two-coloured oblong cake usually covered with an almond paste? Is it red velvet cake, fondant fancy, angel cake or Battenberg? Right, so, Napoleon quickies there, the old arms, talking Torquette, Mount Pleasant Pheasants up there, Maren Parr, Nantwich Star, George D, all getting the fastest finger. And that's Battenberg, 96%. This is the easiest round we've had to start with. Apparently, something else is spelt wrong as well. Oh, we're having a disaster on spelling. I did write this at about 11 o'clock last night. So have we got George D, Maren Parr, Nantwich Star, Napoleon, DHD, President Pedro, Bet to the Future in 7th, Northern Taffy's jumped up in 8th, Big Ike, Johnny Knowledge, Mr. and Mrs. C in the Shores 11. Okay, so are we ready? Next question on food. What does HP stand for and HP source? Harry Potter, Hamish and Parker, Houses of Parliament or Hovey's Pedigree? HP and HP Source Leftovers, Napoleon, Nantwich Star, Miss Annie G, The Fletchers, Stefan and Can't Be Bothered. Can't bother to answer the questions, but they've answered quick. Yep, 80% of you getting. I didn't think that many would get that. I thought that was a tricky one. Yeah, HP stands for Houses of Parliament. There's a picture of the Houses of Parliament on the bottle. That's what they were named after. So Nantwich Stars jumped up into the top spot. Maren Parr, now for movement number two. George D in third, Napoleon fourth. President Pedro back to the future, Norman Taffy's big Ike after the first round. Lots of teams, look at that. We have 142 teams currently getting 5 out of 5. Okay, so your next round is cocktails. Cocktails. Are we ready? Next one, number six. What cocktail's this? Is it a cosmopolitan, a mojito, a Bellini, or an espresso martini? The Fletchers know the cocktails, they'll quit there. 1.69 seconds. GLM, Napoleon, Jamie and Briny. Briny definitely knows the cocktails. And Tater Tots and Jazz, getting this right. Yeah, that's Mojito. God, this is going to be a high point score tonight. 98% of you getting that right. Did say it was an easy one. Could be very tight if he carries on like this. Napoleon's now jumped to the top. It's all on time now. George D, Nantwich Stars dropped. President Pedro, Maren Parr, Bet to the Future. Nicholas just told me Mojito means small wet one in Spanish. So, small wet one. Right, it's ready for the next question. What cocktail consisting of rum, coconut milk and pineapple juice is this? Is it Sex on the Beach or a Pina Colada? So, Napoleon quit there. President Pedro. All these Napoleon Dynamite characters being quit tonight. That is a Pina Colada, 97% of you getting that right, Pina Colada. Still, everyone getting these right tonight, look at this, how many have we got? 139! Sahara and Kayaking Club, at the end of the 7 out of 7s, down to time. But it's better to take your time and get it right than lose points by being quick. Especially when you're up the top. So. Next one. Which popular cocktail contains tequila, triple sec, and lime juice? Drop Stars, Bet to the Future, D, Shut Up Jazz, Nantwich Star, Clifford Turns, and Jazz. Yeah, Jazz should know that one. Which popular cocktail contains tequila, triple sec, and lime juice? It is a margarita. Yep, margarita, 69% of you getting that right. Napoleon up and top, no smooth. Nantwich Star jump back up in second. President Pedro, Bet to the Future. Deep Fletcher's Shores 11. And the Old Arms up top 8 spaces. So two more cocktail questions on their way. Right, here we go, number 9. Porn Star Martini is usually served with a shot of what at the side? Martini with double I. Wine, champagne, prosecco or vodka. Shropshire Stars, Leftovers, Lockdown Lovers, Napoleon, Sean and Tom, and Shut Up Jazz. Fastest there. Lockdown Lovers got kicked out and missed the first three questions. So, playing catch up. Prosecco, yes, 69% of you getting that. Prosecco is what my wife drinks quite a lot of. Their favourite cocktail, Porn Star Martini. So we've got the Rabbits that have crept up 5 spots. The Hills are now in the top 10 as well. We've got D crept up. Dan Beth and Big Bad Moody. Let's get the picture of them up. There they are. Got the Old Arms creeping up 3 spots. Shores 11 have crept up 3. Right, last one of the cocktails. Here we go. Which drink consists of a house mix of tomato juice, vodka, and spices? Is it Bloody Mary, a Tom Collins, or a Moscow Mule? Napoleon, the Mount Pleasant Pheasants, George D, Shropshire Stars, D, Lindos Lunds, Nantwich Star, and Big Les. All came that quick and correct. Yeah, that's a Bloody Mary. 100% of you getting that right. We never had. Maybe it's too easy tonight. Made them too easy. Lots of 10 out of 10s. Lots of 10 out of 10s. Berry 4 plus 2 have jumped up. So how many teams now have 10 questions? We have 73 teams on 10 out of 10. Bet to the Future dropped a point somewhere. Jazz dropped a point somewhere. So next round is kids' books. 5 questions about kids' books. So let's go. Number 11. Which of these animals does the mouse not meet in the Gruffalo? The fox, squirrel, owl, or snake? This is my son's favourite book. He absolutely adores it. So the garden gnomes, the Fletchers, school fish, Johnny Knowledge, Miss Annie G, and Berry. Game this. If you've got kids, you should know this one. We've watched this and read this a million times. Yeah, that's squirrel, 66%. He's fox, owl, and snake. If you've seen the TV program, the squirrels narrate it, but they never meet the mouse. Don't in the book. So the Fletchers up into first spot, jumped up 8. Then the rabbits, the hills, shut up, Jazz. Dan, Beth, and Big Bad Moody, a draft called Bob, Bessie, Joan Co., the Tharbys, and the Seymours, JLC, and Berry 4 plus 2. Up at the top. Right, next. Which book would you find the creature, the Samiad? The Samiad, is it 5 Children and It, Winnie the Pooh, The Secret Garden, and The Lion, The Witch, and The Wardrobe? The Mount Pleasant Pheasants, Moran Park, The Valiant Ducks, Nantwich Star, Cliftons, and Shropshire Stars. Quick on this. Mount Pleasant Pheasants getting up on this fastest finger a lot tonight. Yeah, 60% you're getting 5 Children and It. Recently, just done as a new movie, just so it's been released this week, called 5 Kids in It, a retelling of it. And the Samiad's little sand monster, if you can remember the old BBC programme, pops out. It's like, ooh. So we've got the Fletchers still in the top spot. Draft called Bob jumped up 4. Joan Co., The Hills, Dan Ben, Biff Bad, Big Bad Moody, Shut Up Jazz. Berry, you're up! This first, Berry, you're up in the top. And Baz and Rach. How many teams have we got still on? 12, so it's reducing. I've got Maid and Darwin as the last team. 30 teams now on 12 out of 12. Slowly narrowing down. Right, number 13. Which famous children's book is this? The Tiger Is Tamed for Tea, Where the Wild Things Are, We're Going on a Bear Hunt, or The Wind in the Willows? The Garden Gnomes are straight in on that, 0.48 seconds. And then the Fletchers, then the Cliftons, then the Mount Pleasant Pheasants. What book is this an illustration of? So, we're going on a bear hunt. 92% of you getting that right. Fletchers, still at the top. Fletchers are previous winners. So we've got Joan Co. Captain Jojo. We've got the Hills now in third. Barry climbing up. Dan Beth climbing up. Have we got now? Have we dropped any? We have dropped. No, we've still got 30. Still got 30 teams on 13 out of 13. Your next one. In which Roald Dahl book are the antagonists eventually beaten by the Mugglewumps? James and the Giant Peach, the Twits, the BFG, or the Witchies? Fanny and Jim, fast there. 2.99 seconds. Got Shaw's 11, The Inquisitors, Johnny Knowledge, GLM, and Berry. All getting this correct. And in the fastest time, Giles asking, how did the Samiad go? I think he was a bit like, ooh. Someone make a gif out of that and be posting that on Facebook. I love this. Look at this. That was the Twits, by the way. 53% you're getting the Twits, but just got a call out to the Marios. Look at that with their Ecke's Rory Meg quiz mug. Merchandise is available, just check out the bottom of the YouTube. Love that, guys, thank you. Right, I do believe someone's already made a gif of me doing the Samiad impression. And, oh no, no, it's Giles doing the Samiad impression. Right, one more on the kids. Berry jumped up in second now, Mario's third, Quizzy B's in fourth. Here we go. 15. Which children's author wrote Gangster Granny? Roald Dahl, J.K. Rowling, David Walliams, or Julie Donaldson? Fanny and Jim were quick, the Fletchers were quick. Mount Pleasant Pheasants, Clifford Turner's The Three Dings, Martin Parr, and D.H.D. Up there. So, which children's author wrote Gangster Granny? Don't know if it's spelled right, I think it is. David Welling, 97% you're getting that right. So not a lot of movement at the top. After three rounds, we've got the Fletchers, Berry, the Marios, Quizzy Bees, Two Men and a Lady, Medley Relay Matthews, the Squires, the Flu Fighters, Better Late Than Never, we've got Red Hot Quizzy Peppers, Team Names, Sahara and Kayaking Club, and Maid and Darwin, all getting 15 out of 15. It's amazing. Look at that new camera. Oh, there's Johnny Burgess just trailing. I think I will get a got quiz merchandise, but I think we need a Johnny Burgess shout out t-shirt making. Right, then what's your next round? Fashion, picture round. So, I'll show you an item of clothing. You need to name the decade that you would wear that item. So what decade is this item of clothing associated with? Let's see the first one. Here we go. So which decade was this in fashion? Was it 1910s, 20s or 30s? So, which decade was this in fashion? So 1910s, 20s or 30s. GLM, Can't Be Bothered, the Colbys, Berry, Clifford Turner's Rabbits and Monday Mayhem, all getting that right and quick in about 2 seconds. Yep, 95% you're guessing the 20s. Like 20s. So not a lot of change at the top. Did everyone get that right? What have we got? Still 13 teams on 16 out of 16. Who got that wrong? Let's have a look. New camera. What? Oh no, Johnny Burgess, you jumped down by 52 spots by getting one question wrong. That's a shocker. Shaw's 11 jumped down by 55 spots. Yeah, that is from the 1920s. Right, here we go. Next one. Which decade was this in fashion? The 70s, the 80s, or the 90s? Berry straight in. I think that's because Ben's still got one. Wilmslow, I know Shorty's definitely got one. GLM, the Inquisitors. Luke, it's Malvern. The Colbys and the Shop Stars. Advan looks like he's the type of guy that owns one of these. So, what is it? It's the 80s, 72% you're getting that right. It's a shell suit from the 1980s. I remember going to a non-uniform day at Woodhouse, our middle school year. God, what have we been? 86, 87? And every single person went in a shell suit. Literally the whole school wore shell suits. So Barry, take a screenshot, guys. You're up in the top spot. Fletchers went 90s. Dropped 8 spots. Dropped first place. In fact, we've lost a few teams there. There's only 8 teams now on 17 out of 17. But shell suits are definitely known from the 80s. Okay. Now, what's your next one? I could have duplicated decades. Might be the same answer for 2 questions. You never know. Here we go. Next one. Which decade was this in fashion? 60s, 70s or 80s? Can't Be Bothered, President Pedro's, the Colbys, Joan Coe, the Dinosaurs. First time up here tonight. And Norman Taffy's on the fastest finger. Someone has asked if we can have a leaderboard at the end of the people who answer the fastest. I will try and get that put together for next week. It'd be a good idea. Right, 1970s, 89% you're getting, yeah, Flares from the 70s. Berry's still at the top. Has it changed much at the top? Got Berry's the Quizzy Bees, Two Men and a Lady. Who's the team captain on that? Tracy. The Squires. Better Late Than Never, Maiden Darwin's, Horn Kayaking Club, and Clifford Turner's. 7 teams on 18 out of 18. That's where it starts getting tense. Giles just messaged, so wish I knew how to make a GIF. I'm sure one of me will be floating around tomorrow. Right, next one. Which decade was this in fashion? I remember dressing like this. 80s, 90s or 2000s. Definitely remember dressing like this. Going to the very first V Festival. Napoleon, the Colbys, Berry. I think I know a couple of people that still dress like that. Kyle Gibb. Fletchers, Wilmslow, and the Dinosaurs, Fastest Finger. 1990s, 88% of you getting that right. Yeah, that's the 90s. Two Men, the Lady, and Nick and Tracy Brown. So Nick and Tracy up in third place. Berry's up in first. Quizzy Bees second. Better Late Than Never. That's Rob Lee, previous winners a few weeks ago. Now we've got the Squires, got the Maiden Darwin. It's John Hyde. Hi, John. Right, one last one of fashion. So this is for Sarah Pond, by the way. She asked for this round, fashion round. 20, in which decade was this in fashion? So, was it 1990s, the 2000s, or the 2010s? So, Gib just messaged to say that Keely can no longer answer because she's laughing so hard that I've called him out for dressing this like he's still in the 90s. That's the 2000s. 2000s. Berry have dropped. Oof. Dropped from the top spot. Yep, that's jeans. Dress over jeans. 2002. That's when that was popular. 2002. Did my research yesterday. Can't think of her name. Is it Rachel someone? But yeah, that's from 2002. So, two men, a lady. So, Nick and Tracy have taken the top spot. The Quizzy Bees in second. Better late than never. The Squires, Horan Kayaking Club. They're the only five teams now. 20 out of 20. Kerry's probably punching Ben or the other way around at this point for dropping down off first place. Right, your next round, what are we on? General knowledge. So, like I said, back to basics this week. Nothing too complicated. Five general knowledge questions. Next one. Which museum does the Mona Lisa hang? Is it the Louvre? Is that how you pronounce it? The Louvre? The Guggenheim? The British Museum? Or the MoMA? The British Museum, that should be. Or the MoMA? I did correct these spellings. It really worries me that some of these spellings are still wrong because I think we're going to have a bit of a nightmare with two questions later. I don't think it's applied my fixes from this morning. The Louvre, 97% of you. I'm convinced we are going to have a disaster later on. So apologies in advance. Nothing I can do about it now. Once the quiz starts, nothing I can do. Two men, a lady. Got that. Yep, 97% of you got that right. Still five teams and 21 out of 21, but it could all get screwed up when the whole quiz falls apart in a bit. Because, yeah, it could be a complete disaster. We will see. Obviously, the later rounds, it got later at night, and I made a mess. I did correct it all this morning, but I don't think it's applied. Right, 22. Which of Henry... How many of Henry VIII's wives were executed? One, two, or three? One, two, or three. Nicholas asking, is it typical British to write Brish? No, not at all. So, how many of Henry VIII's wives were executed? One, two, or three? It's 281% of you got that. There's a rhyme. I can't remember what it is, but there's a rhyme. Died, beheaded, something or other. Survived. But yeah, still, them teams hanging on. Quizzy Bees have jumped up now, though. Jumped into the top spot. Charlie, team captain. Better late than never, the Squires and Sarn Kayaking Club. Berries have disappeared. Oh, there they are. They've got another one rung down to 36th. So, let's go. Next one. 23. Robert Galbraith, as I pronounce it, is the pseudonym of which popular author? Agatha Christie, J.K. Rowling, or Roald Dahl? Robert Galbraith is the pseudonym of which popular author? Agatha Christie, J.K. Rowling, or Roald Dahl? Clifford Turner's Fanny and Jim, the Vegemitist, Agatha Christie, the McFittins, Smugsy and Mother, 1951. All quick there. Yeah, J.K. Rowling, 56% of you getting that right. Right, two questions for the halfway mark before we all fall apart. God help us. God help us. I'm positive two questions are going to go wrong later. See, we'll know in two rounds time. Right, here we go. Number 24. What's the Queen's surname? Is it Mountbatten, Mountbatten Windsor, or Windsor? School of Fish, the Leftovers, the Moss Rats, Johnny Knowledge, Fitton D, Miss IG, and Big Ike getting out. That's Fitton D. Fitton. Right. they all got it right in 2 seconds. Windsor, 65% of you getting that right. So on Kayaking Club, got it wrong. Clifford Turner's Inquisitor's got that wrong. Yeah, her surname is Windsor. Her children's take the surname Mountbatten Windsor, but her surname is Windsor. Didn't check this because I would have gone Mountbatten Windsor, but yeah, it's the House of Windsor, but only her children take Mountbatten Windsor. Right, one more before the halfway point where things fall apart. Here we go. What is the innermost colour of the rainbow? Is it violet, red, indigo, or blue? Leftovers, none. Taffy, School of Fish, Clifford Turner, Sam Jam, Fanny and Jim getting that right. So, what is the innermost colour of the rainbow? It's violet. Richard of York gave battle in vain. Only 49% of you getting that right. The Quizzy Bees got it wrong. They went blue. Yeah. Richard of York gave battle in vain. Gained inwards. Two men and a lady back in the top spot. And better late than never, both on 25. Got lots of teams on 24, lots on 23. So, that's it. Right, take a few seconds. Top your drinks up. Relieve yourselves. Stop panicking. We are halfway, 1 minute break. So, leaderboard stands, two men and a lady, then better late than never. We've got XXXX, Quizzy Bees, Cotton Town. That's Cotton Town up on the leaderboard. Sean Tom jumped up. My name's Ecke. Daydreaming Blands, this time up on the leaderboard tonight, they jumped up. Who's at the bottom? That's what Nick wants now. I could only see 200. So A&J currently at the bottom. BK25, me, Mossrats, Single Faller. Is that Keith by himself tonight? Missing Rach, obviously affecting tonight. We've got Morgan, Big Les, Ostipop, the BB, Robertson, Nicholas, Bradley Brunt, the Lovett, Bruce 2020, the Wings, the Buyer, down at the bottom tonight. Give them a shout out because they don't normally get shout outs. Right, so everyone get ready, we'll start up again now. From the berry is Ben accusing Kerry of being wrong on the questions, losing in the top spot. Just messaged. Right, next round. Movies, picture round. Name the movie. I'll show you a picture from the movie and just name the movie. So here we go. Everyone ready? Everyone sat back down, got the drinks. 26. Name the movie. Dumb and Dumber, Ace Ventura, Liar Liar, or The Truman Show. President Pedro, The Inquisitors, Clifford Turner's, Jamie and Briony. Tharby's, Barry and Seymour's getting that right. And the quickest times, just under 2 seconds. So, yeah. What movie is this from? One of my favourites. Ace Ventura, 84% of you getting that right. Not a lot of change at the top. Sean Tom crept up a spot. Cotton Town moved down the spot. Squires jumped back up. So on Kayaking Club jumped up too. 99 problems. But the beach ain't won. Tom and Linz have hit the top 10. So family affair tonight in the top 10 then. Right, so here we go, your next one. Name the movie. Goodfellas, Carlito's Way, The Godfather, or The Departed. Napoleon, George D, President Pedro, The Leftovers. God, Gnome, School of Fish, and Berry. Quick again, berries are on fire tonight. Right, so Godfather, yeah, 93% of you getting that right, that's The Godfather. Nice and easy one. No change. Not a lot of change. A few people creeping up. So on Kayaking Club are desperate to crawl back. Do like it when it's close like this though. Not a lot in it tonight. Lots of teams on 25. Lots of teams on 24. Got the Rabbits in 32nd place. Shrubs of Stars in 31st. Fletchers in 30th. Now Squires dropped. Oof, Squires have just dropped 21 points, getting that wrong. Ouch. Look at that, Sean Tom dropped 15 points. Yep, that is Godfather 2. Or Godfather, should I say. Right, 28. Name the movie. Star Wars New Hope, Star Wars The Empire Strikes Back, Star Wars The Force Awakens, or Star Wars Rogue One. So which Star Wars film is it? Gone, Gnomes, Fear More, School Fish, Leftovers, Joy Knowledge, and Red Hot Quizzy Peppers. That's Nomi and Johnny getting that right. So, yeah, that's The Empire Strikes Back, Luke versus Vader. 79% you're getting that, so not a lot of change. So, Kayaking Club still creeping up. My name's Ecke, creeping up. Surely this is my regular teams. It's got to be Badders and Chris and all those guys. 99 problems. Oh, now in 7th. Chasing the in-laws. Talk and Talkette are creeping up. Great Bradley Wiggins. Leftovers and Dan, Beth and Big Man Moody. Right, number 29. We ready? Name the Indiana Jones movie. Raiders of the Lost Ark, Temple of Doom, Last Crusade, or Kingdom of the Crystal Skull. Indiana Jones movie. School of Fish, Leftovers, Kanye for President, Spuds, Robin Knight and Smugsy. Game really quick there, 2 seconds. I don't know if you notice, I've increased it on the YouTube stream, so the pictures come up bigger. That's Raiders of the Lost Ark. Whew. Big split there. Yeah, very start of the first Indiana Jones film, before the big ball rolls after him. So yeah. It's a Han Kayaking Club. Oh, dropped that one. They went Temple of Doom. Temple of Doom and dropped 14 points. Daydream Blends crept up 6 though. Armin Zola as Never. M&B. Allard, Seymour's Mill, Berry 4 plus 2 up there. Come on, you Saints. It's Craig Bennett. Clifford Turner's crept back in. Right. 30. Name the movie. 7, The X-Files, Flight Plan, or Silence of the Lambs. What film's this? Fletcher's, quick, Smugsy. Smugsy, you're on. Smugsy, I don't know if you heard my apology earlier for not recognising that you've won multiple times now, so congratulations, Smugsy, that are been very, very well recently. Silence of the Lambs, 93%, you got Silence of the Lambs. Two Men and a Lady, Better Late Than Never. XXX, Cotton Town, My Name's Ecke, 99 Problems. Leftovers, and Clifford Turner's up in the top. Right, next round, I'm going to mute this music. Let's get rid of the intense music. Right, so this is your music round for tonight. It's called Fruit. The titles, I don't think the artists, the titles of all of these songs mention a piece of fruit. Now, this is where it could go disastrous if the quiz hasn't uploaded correctly. I think it has. We've gone so well so far, but this is where it could go completely disastrous, so we will see. Because I do remember this morning one was wrong. Don't know which, can't remember which. I just remember one being wrong. So just name the fruits. One very tricky one in here tonight. I've tried to go with a little bit more obscure songs, but we'll see. So it starts on YouTube. You may play muted on your device. You know the crack now. You may have to click the play button. And it will be slightly delayed on the stream because we are about 4 seconds behind because of the way YouTube allows us to stream. So here we go. Your first one coming up. Name the fruit. I want your belly and that summer feeling, getting washed away in you. Breathe me in, breathe me out. I don't know if I could ever go without. Right. So, what was that? Is it strawberry, watermelon, grapes, or mango? We'll know if the quiz has worked because now you've all pressed. This is the one that you got wrong earlier. Yep, the quiz is wrong. Yep, those 5%, well done, because it was watermelon. Oh dear god. Yeah, that should have been watermelon, so apologies to everyone for this. I fixed this morning. Watermelon gates, there's always, every week something goes wrong. Don't know why this didn't upload. I uploaded it, I reset it. Apologies. I'll try and correct the leaderboard if it makes a difference after. Everyone got that wrong though, apart from 9 people. So yeah, hopefully I think there's one more question round later in the quiz as well, but we'll see. Apologies. Right, next one. In a factory downtown. If I had my little way, oof, tricky one. Obscure 90s song there. Really obscure 90s song. So, is that oranges, melon, peaches, or plum? Definitely not mango. Mango Gate. Well, I've just been told XXX is the Brent family, by the way. Brents are on tonight, doing well. It's Cadbury's Express, the quickest there. Gareth knowing his 90s rock music. That's Peaches, yeah, it's President of the USA and Peaches. Got me from about 96, I think. Yep. XXXX. Got that right. Right, Two Men Laid, Bell Lane, Never. My name's Ecke. Cotton Town, 99 Problems, The Leftovers, Clifford Turner's. We've got Dan Beth and Big Bad Moody. Great Bradley Wiggins, Talking Talkette, and Barry 4 plus 2. Getting that right. Right then. Are we ready for your next one? 33. Name the fruit. So we've got the brownies quick answering there, Paul and Karen. Got the moss rats. Clifford Turner's Agatha Quiztea quick on that one. Talking Talk at Wilmslow, Captain Bill and his Big Chopper and Big Les answering very quick on that. So, what was the fruit? Yep, blueberry, Blueberry Hill. Is that Fats Domino? I think. Let's see, Blueberry Hill. Yeah, Fats Domino, I thought it was. Harry Styles, oh, I'm getting it all in now. Lucy, 5, SOS, Harry Styles Gate, yep. It's Watermelon Gate tonight. There's going to be one other as well. Sam Menzies, we don't have scores move up and down coming up at the bottom each question this week. Just refresh now while paused. If your screen is frozen, you can refresh and it should bring it back for you. Do it now before I click on the button. I'll give you a few seconds. My name's Ecke, got that wrong, went Blackberry. Okay, are we ready? Next one, 34. Name the fruits.
Daylight come and me wan go home.
Well, a song. Coconut, pineapple, papaya or banana? Coconut, pineapple, papaya or banana? Mom and Pa, Red Hot, Quizzy, Peppers, Johnny Knowledge, Talking Talk Out, The Old Arm, Sally H and the Brownies. Getting that right. That's banana. Yeah, it's the Banana Boat song by Harry Belafonte. So, better late than never. Got that wrong. They went coconuts. That leaves two men and a lady on 33. Everyone else, 32. So, Nick and Tracy up ahead. What happened to 99 Problems? Down to 14th. Dropped to 8 places. Getting coconut. Not the coconut song. Nicholas says you should have played the banana phone song. I haven't heard that in a long time. Right, last one of this round. Name the fruits. What is she? What is she? She's my. Is it apple, cherry, blackberry, or raspberry? Wilmslow, quit there. Johnny Knowledge, Baz and Rachel, The Garden Gnomes, Shores 11, Napoleon and Gigi, SHSH. Oh, Nicholas saying, she's my watermelon. Yep. Why is the one question every week? There's going to be another later. I'm telling you now. Yep, cherry. Yeah, cherry pie. That's Warrant and cherry pie. Right, two men and a lady. XXX. Cotton Town. Better late than never. Look at this. Look at this. The Brent family. Dimple used the name tonight, and they're doing really well. Better late than never than fourth. My name's Ecke. And fifth, Clifford Turner's Talking Talkette. Berry 4 plus 2. Mill and Almondzola is never. Alan and M&B tops tonight. Right, what's your next round? It is Badly Drawn Dinosaurs. This is a round donated last week by Co Vincent Van Koff, as he'd like to be known. He's asked to remain anonymous. I think these are brilliant. Not quite at the level of Chloe's, but not far off. So here we go. Name the dinosaur from the picture. That's it. It's that simple. Right. Here we go. Name the dinosaur. Velociraptor, Tyrannosaurus Rex, Brontosaurus, or Apatosaurus. Jeff Harrison saying, you should tell us which one's wrong, then we can all get the answer and it won't matter. I genuinely can't remember. I can't remember which one it was. I just remember there was one more that I had to correct towards the end. That was a Tyrannosaurus. T-Rex, 99% of you getting that, nice and easy. Let me have a scoop down my answers to see if I can remember which one it was that was wrong earlier. How do you get history up on this? I haven't got a clue. Don't know. I really do not know. But there's definitely one more that's wrong. Sarah Russ saying, show us the answers. No. So has that affected anything? It's not. Top of the leaderboard's not changed. Next one. What dinosaur is this? Where's my music gone? Dinosaur is this? Stegosaurus, Ankylosaurus, Triceratops, or Compsognathus? Compsognathus. I can pronounce these because my son is watching a Dinosaur A to Z on Amazon every day at the moment that he loves singing along to. Stegosaurus, Ankylosaurus, Triceratops, or Compsognathus. Triceratops. How can you not know that? 80% getting that right. Top spot. Yep, everyone's got that. Not a lot of movement. Did anyone get it wrong? Inconsistently. Give him Keely. Come on. Stegosaurus. It's obviously Triceratops. The Wards gave Stegosaurus as well, and so did Spuds. So, look at that. Spain Waste House G's in 71st place tonight. Right, next one. Are you ready? Prepare to be wowed by another badly drawn dinosaur. What type of dinosaur is this? Is it a Stegosaurus, Velociraptor, Ankylosaurus, or Spinosaurus? So, what type of dinosaur is this? Stegosaurus. Yep, Stegosaurus, 95% here, getting that right. It is a Stegosaurus. You got it wrong. No change at the top. Two men and a lady holding on to this tonight. But they've got a few teams chasing them. Can be holding for the last round, though. Three fighters went Spinosaurus. Not quite. That is your Stegosaurus. That good quality pitch there. Drawing. Looks like a photograph. See, there's no expenses spared with these art rounds we have on this quiz. Only go for the finest artists. Right, 39. What type of dinosaur is this? Gallimimus, Megalosaurus, Diplodocus, or Ichthyosaur? Gallimimus, Megalosaurus, Diplodocus, or Ichthyosaur. So, what is that? I love his sunshine. Looks like a dog's paw print. Diplodocus, 88% of you getting that right. Yeah, that is obviously a Diplodocus. But who didn't get it? Seymour's went this Ichthyosaur. Ichthyosaur's a fish. Ichthyosaur is a fish. Or a lizardy fish type thing. Not a lot of change though at the top. Dungeon Alfie, look at that. Jumped up 19th. That's your highest, I think. Doing well tonight. Nine problems, still holding on at 13th there. Right, next. Badly drawn dinosaur. Last one. Badly drawn. What dinosaur is this? Velociraptor. Ecosaurus. Pterosaur or Brachiosaurus. A Velociraptor and Ecosaurus. Pterosaur or Brachiosaurus. Mossrat's team name. John. Dum Dummer. Napoleon and Mount Pleasant Pheasants. Quick on that one. Can't be bothered. Also. Oh, there's no pick! That was one of the other things that went wrong. There's no pick. Brachiosaurus! I've not noticed the picture never came up. Oh, God. Picture didn't show? No, it didn't. That was the other one. Yep, there we go. There we go. So, yeah, well done to the 34 people that went Brachiosaurus. Two men and a lady guessed that right as well. All a guess. Oh, God. At least you knew it wasn't an Ecosaurus. Did anyone put Ecosaurus? No. 5% of people, 10 people went with that. The famously invisible Brachiosaurus. Hopefully it's right. Yeah, hopefully everything's right from this point on. Disastrous. Disastrous. I'm going to work on the site this week so I can fix answers as we go. Yeah, definitely fix the answers as we go. Yeah, it's the famously invisible Brachiosaurus belongs to the ninja family. Right. Mass celebrities. I'll show you a celebrity in a mask. Tell me who it is. That simple. Yeah, COVID masks. Everyone's masked up at the moment, so why not do a celebrity round where instead of hiding their eyes like I'd normally do in the pub, I hide their mouths. So, who is this? Hopefully all these pictures show. Who's this? Named celebrity. Chris Pratt, Ben Affleck or Tom Cruise? George D. The Fletchers, Kanye President, Bruce 2020, Nantwich Star and Barry. Quick on this one. Who is that? Ben Affleck, 78%, you're getting that right. Yep, that's Ben Affleck in a mask. Shades, because you have to pair masks with shades. Alright, hopefully everything's right from this point on, but I really don't know now. I haven't got a clue. I remember thinking this morning, I'm so glad I've done a dry run through so I can fix these issues, fix the spelling mistakes, fix the wrong questions. And I should have paid attention to the emails I got from the hosting saying something hadn't built right, but I didn't think it'd kick it out. Anyway, 42. Name the celebrity. Naomi Campbell, Rihanna or Beyonce. Tough one this is. Okay, full extreme masked and bodysuits and everything. Mossrat's the Fletchers, George Dean, GLM. Great, right. Dumb and Dumber and Just Me. I think this one could split. This could split people. Really tough. Look at the eyes. Whose eyes are those? 50% you're getting it right. It is Naomi Campbell. And Two Men and a Lady. Oof. Nick and Tracy doing amazing tonight. Mill got it wrong though, didn't answer in time. Clifford Turner's XXXX Cottontown. My name's Ecke, M&B, Ella, better late than never, 99 problems back in the leaderboard. Who have we lost? Barry 4 plus 2 dropped, Dan Beth and Big Bad Moody dropped, and Talking Talkette dropped. Next one, 43. Name the celebrity, Sarah Michelle Gellar, Reese Witherspoon, Holly Willoughby. Who is that? Mossrat's Quizzy Lizzie, Lindos Lunds, Danielle, and me. Dinosaurs and Lovets. Getting that right in the fastest time in 2 seconds. Well, Mossrat's in less than a second. Who is that? That's the other one that was wrong. Yep. Right, we've got all the wrong ones out of the way now. Obviously not Holly Willoughby. It's obviously Reese Witherspoon. But it's not affected anywhere in the top of the leaderboard. See how bad this went last night, yep. See how bad it went last night? I have no idea how I wrote the answers down to these wrong last night. I corrected them all this morning. Going terrible. It's going terrible, guys. Most disastrous one yet. At least you all got it wrong, apart from you lucky eight. So, I will recalculate the leaderboard tomorrow to see what difference it makes. I don't think it's going to make any difference, but we'll recalculate tomorrow. Right, next one. Name the celebrity. Tom Hanks, Sacha Baron Cohen or Arnold Schwarzenegger? Did Reese go to an Italian restaurant and bring the table clothing back? I think so. Who's that? Tom Hanks, Sacha Baron Cohen or Arnold Schwarzenegger? Or Mossrat's Fletcher's Wilmslow, George D. Spending my sausages. BK25 and Scumbag College on the fastest finger. That's Arnie. Yeah, I thought this was Tom Hanks. His t-shirt actually says Arnold, and he is Arnold Schwarzenegger. But yeah, I looked at it last night, and I showed Janine earlier when I was testing it on her, and she said Tom Hanks as well. But yeah, it's Arnie. 75% of you. Oh, look at this. Two men and a lady thought it was Tom Hanks as well. Dropped a point, but it's made no difference. They were two ahead. Made absolutely no difference, so they're still in the lead. 99 problems crept up though, jumped up three. Someone said a brachiosaur named Holly singing. they just deleted it. I was reading out the joke, but I think they spelled it wrong, so they've just taken it off. Right, next one, last celebrity. Who's this? Gary Barlow, Sam Cowell, Robbie Williams. Oof, quick on this one. Dumb and Dumber, Adam Leanne. Captain Bill, Nantwich Star, Lindos Lunds, and Kate and Simon. Fastest night. Less than 2 seconds, they know that one. Yeah, Robbie Williams, 98% of you getting that. 98% of you. So, that is it for the Mass Celebs. Fingers crossed this last round goes okay. Three wrong tonight. Disaster. Disaster. But at least majority of people got them wrong. It's not affected the leaderboard. I don't think it's affected the top 10 at all. So, not much change at the top spot. The top 10 teams haven't moved after that question. So, last round, calendar. All questions about calendar. You're going to have to think on your feet for this. Think quick. Think quick. Right. Are there more days in the first 6 months of the year or the last 6 months of the year? First 6 months of the year or last 6 months of the year? Can't be bothered. Leftovers, Back to the Future, Captain Bill, Shut Up Jazz, Seymour's, Jazz, and the McFittins. All. Fastest finger there. First 6 months or last 6 months, more days? Last 6 months, yeah, 89% you're getting that. There are 181 days in the first 6 months and 184 in the last on a normal year. But even on a leap year, an extra day doesn't make any difference. Right, these are where the tough questions come now. Finishing with a few tricky ones. Not much change there, but this could completely mix it up. Let's see if two men and a lady can hold on for four questions. Four tough questions. Right. Which one month is the longest out of the year? Think about this. January, May, October, December. Which is the longest month of the year? January, May, October, December. The Leftovers, Big Lead, Smugsy, Bet to the Future, Cat Biscuits, QS, Manic Monday, and Can't Be Bothered have got this. So, the longest one. Longest month of the year. Lots of teams just answering in time. Lots of people thought about this. 28% here. Getting it split. It's October. The clock goes back. You have an extra hour. October has one more hour than all of the other months that have 31 days. Whew. Two men and a lady got that. Not, I don't think anyone can catch him. Can just about catch him if they mess up. Clifford Turner's got that wrong. Brent's got that wrong. My name's Ecke. 99 Problems got that right. Talking Torquette. Mill got it wrong. Yeah, December's the longest with 8 letters. It wasn't. I wasn't on about letters. I was on about amount of time in a month. Yeah. So yeah, wasn't meant to be. None of these are meant to be tricks like that. Yeah, October has one extra hour because of the clocks going back. Right. Let's go. 48. What type of calendar do we use now? Is it the Julian calendar or the Gregorian calendar? Leftovers, Sandwich Star, Shores 11, Visible as Muck, Big Les and George D. Getting that one right in less than 2 seconds. The Julian or Gregorian? Yes, Gregorian. 68% of you getting that right. It's mucked a few people up. Yeah, the Gregorian calendar is the calendar that's most used in the world. It's named after Pope Gregory VIII, who introduced it in 1582. The Julian calendar was named after Julius Caesar, I think, and was used previously. Right, 99 Problems dropped one. Two questions left. Can they creep back up? Can Mill hold it? Can the Clifford Turners hold it? My name's Ecke. I think it's My Name's Ecke. Highest position tonight. the Brents. The Brents have, two men and a lady. Get this, they've won. Let's see. In which month is Burns Night celebrated in Scotland? January, February, October, November. So what night is Burns Night celebrated in? Famous Scottish holiday. Hopefully I've got this one right. Yeah, January, 68% you're getting that right. Oh, the top spot. Two men and a lady got it. Are they cheering? I believe they must be cheering at home. Nobody can catch them. We've got this week's winner early. So, everything to play for now is for the top 10. Top 10, 99 problems. Can the Bee Gees get into the top 5 again tonight? Can Mill hold it? We also have got quite a few teams on 42. Fletcher's dropped a point there. M&B dropped a point. Part in town. So, and Kayaking Club dropped. One question left. Think about this one, guys. Think about this one. It's a toughie to finish on. Here we go. Which of these years will not be a leap year? The year 2000, the year 2048, or the year 2100, which is not a leap year? Cat Biscuits QS, No Mean Ginger Me, The Old Arms, The Garden Gnomes, Mr. and Mrs. C, The BB, and Can't Be Bothered, all getting that right. And in a quick time, in 4 seconds. Yeah, 2100, 62% here. Leap years, if the number's evenly divisible by 400, it's a leap year. If it's divisible by 100 but not 400, it's not a leap year. If the year's both divisible by 100 and 400, then it is a leap year. Simple, obviously. So that's it. I can only apologise enough for the messed up questions. I know you all have a laugh. I do. 1 week, I just want to get it right. I go over this so many times. I corrected all these issues earlier. I'm convinced we were going to have a flawless quiz tonight. And yet again, something goes wrong. So, Watermelon Gate tonight. Brachiosaurus. Holly Willoughby. Oh well. Hopefully you all enjoyed it. Quite enjoyed tonight. Back to basics. No, you know, a few more simple question rounds. Thought it was good. But let's take a look at the results. So, Two Men and a Lady, well done to Nick and Tracy tonight, smashing it, winning tonight. Meg Regulars, always great to see Meg Regulars getting up there. The Brent family in second, XXX. My name's Ecke and I'm Rob, playing golf. These are one of my longest quiz teams. They're in third. Clifford Turners in fourth. The Leftovers in fifth. Talking Torquettes in sixth. Dan, Beth and Big Bang Moody. 2048 is a leap year. It's divisible by 4. Lots of people telling me, sorry, 2048 is not a leap year. If the year is divisible by 4, which I believe 2048 is. Yep. It is a leap year. So, the only time, just to confirm, the only time that... the rules I was giving you are just when it falls on a century. So, obviously, we have a leap year every 4 years. That question was right. The one that is not a leap year, it's 2100. Anyway, back to this. Dan, Beth and Big Bang Moody, Berry 4 plus 2, Come On You Saints, Mill, Almanzolo's Never Been More Alive, Allah, Team Name, 99 Problems, oh, he dropped at the last point. M&B, Smugsy, last week's winners, multiple winners, just to put it out there. They have won multiple times, like 3 times. The Inquisitors, the Seymours, Cottontown, and Better Late Than Never. Simcox, Fletcher's, Napoleon, Spuds, Route 55, Great Bradley Wiggins, Sarah and Steve, the Quizzy Bees, George and Claire, and Adam and Leanne. Just outside top 30 is Linda and Alfie. So that is your top 30 tonight. I'll post the results as ever on Facebook later. Hopefully everyone's enjoyed that. Sorry about the mistakes. 1 week we will get them all right. But it's a laugh, isn't it? And I don't think it's affected stuff too much tonight. Top of the leaderboard didn't seem to change too much off there. Mike said, first time top 3, I think. Not easy doing these. Keep up the good work, mate. Thank you. Great quiz again, Jeff Harrison, despite the last question having 2 right answers. I don't believe it did have two right answers. The question was, which of these is not a leap year? Which of these is not a leap year? 2000 is a leap year. 2048 is a leap year. 2100 is not a leap year. Is that right? 2100. No, 2100 is not a leap year. But 2048 is a leap year. Yep, 2048's a leap year, and 2000's a leap year. So, yeah, just to clear up the confusion there, the question, which of these years will not be a leap year? That's what it said. Adam saying, well done everyone, cheers guys. I didn't see how you did with Mal. Let me know how you did, whether you do better by yourself. Shout out to Phil Hands. Lots of people posting on Facebook, let's see what they say. Yeah, Watermelon Gate tonight. Lots of spelling mistakes tonight. yeah. Phil Hansay, thanks Ecke, always good questions, just some if some of our answers weren't. Yeah. Send me your suggestions, please send me your suggestions of any rounds that you would like to see. And I'm putting the berries on the spot. The berries are going to do their dancing for us next week again. Yeah, I'll see if get another pitch round off Chloe. Callie, get practicing on your xylophone. We always love that. Tim's Tunes is back next week, though. If anyone can think of any other themes for music, you know, we've had fruit, we've had weather, all sorts of things. Let me know your themes for music that would be good. You can keep trying to come up with them. It's better than just asking who sings this. A little bit more interesting. But yeah, thanks for taking part, guys. Not sure when the pub's open. Big shout out to Paul and Karen. They're working very, very hard in the pub. Wednesdays, by the way. Wednesdays are the half-price government scheme at the Meg. So they're open on Wednesday. Book a table if you want to go. I'm sure they'll be busy. So every Wednesday in August is the half-price meals. And yeah, get yourself in the pub, support the pub. I was in there last Thursday. It was great. Great to see so many people in, socially distancing and being sensible. So Avan saying, can we have a computer games round again? Terran Russ, yes you can have them by the way, yeah, love that. Terran Russ saying, great fun on a Monday night. Tom Beach saying, Nick and Tracy definitely use Google, normally struggle to finish in the top 500. Well, they smashed it tonight, absolutely smashed it tonight. So well done to Nick and Tracy, it's so good to see pub regulars winning. Oh no, shocking Sam Menzies. Wasn't it technically more of a style, as in the type that he's tread over in the field, than a gate this week? Yeah, a Harry style. Ooh, that's terrible. Love it though. Sarah Russ Thomas, chocolate bar around was fab. I can do chocolate bars again. Let me make a note of these. What you want? Chocolate bars, computer games. Don't know how many more weeks we're online. We're carrying on going until we can go back in the pub with the way things are going. Don't know if that's going to be anytime soon. But yeah, for the next week or two, I should be around. So thanks again. Post your scores on Facebook. Let me know how you've got on and send any suggestions. By the way, thanks to Jack Hall for drawing the dinosaurs tonight. I know you won't be anonymous, but they were great. So Jack is our dinosaur drawer tonight. Right, thanks guys. I'll see you all next week. Cheers.